Hold tight. If you've come across this video trying to find out a bit more information about the bypass valves in your heating system, then great, we're going to cover them in seconds from now. Before we do that, I'd please like to ask you to subscribe. We do loads of videos every week and all that. We do lots of photos and videos and stuff on our Facebook channel as well. There'll be a link to that coming up in the video. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the video today, and remember everyone to hold tight.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Hold tight and welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video. My name's James and this is going to be a really, really quick video. What we're going to talk about today is bypass valves. Now on this particular system here, we've got a bypass valve that's effectively a gate valve. So that means that you set it at one point and then leave it for the rest of its life. But you can also get automatic bypass valves that are a lot better because they're a lot more efficient for the heating system. But for the purposes of this video, to see where they fit in on a heating system, this particular layout that we've got behind us here is just fine. So if you come over here and have a closer look, I'll give you an idea about what bypass valves do, where they sit and the heating system, and then we'll go back to the whiteboard to show you this lot all laid out schematically. So on this system here, we've got our flow coming up from the boiler here. It goes through the pump and then up. We've got an automatic air vent up there, so that just vents the top of the pump out, and it comes back down here, and this is an S-plan system. At this point here, it's really important. It effectively can go one of three ways. If the radiators are calling for heat, so the programmer's calling for it and also the thermostat's calling, this two-port valve here is going to open up and send a life supply to the boiler and the pump to come on. That's great, brilliant, everything's good. We've got loads of water coming around there. If this tank here is calling for heat, so the programmer's calling for heat and the thermostat on the side of the tank is calling for heat, this two-port valve here is going to open up and send water around the coil of this tank here. Well, funny enough, actually, this tank doesn't actually have a coil on it. It's a tank-in-tank beast. But let's say this tank is not calling for heat, but this radiator valve here, the two-port valve for the radiators, is open. That's where the bypass valve comes in. So say you've got, say, 10 radiators on the heating system, and they've all got thermostatic radiator valves on them. As those thermostatic radiator valves turn down and turn down, on an old system, and also on some of the new systems as well, that's going to cause more stress on the pump. Now, that's where the bypass valve comes in. The bypass valve, especially on the type that we've got here, is set to constantly let a small trickle of water through directly onto the return back to the boiler. And what that means is that you've got a constant flow going around the heating system at all times, regardless of whether the radiators are open or either of the two-port valves are open. This is also really handy if either of these valves fail. So to recap really quickly, the bypass valve ensures that there's a constant flow of hot water around the heating system through the boiler and the pump at all times, regardless of whether there's been a problem with any of the valves or if the TRVs are open or closed. So why do we want to do that? That's the big question. If either of these valves go wrong or there's some sort of problem and flow is completely restricted around the heating system, number one, the pump is going to struggle, okay? Now, on new modern pumps like this Wilo that we've got behind us, they actually know what pressure's coming off them and they can actually turn themselves down automatically, which saves you energy. But even with that function there, it's never going to fully switch itself off. And likewise, with an older pump as well that doesn't have this automatic function on it, they're just going to keep bashing away at the certain speed that they were running at. So that results in a problem with air. You can have cavitation and air problems. I mean, on this system here, if this piece wasn't here and there was air going around, eventually that air is going to come out of that automatic air vent up there. The system pressure is going to drop down, and then the pressure switch on the boiler is going to go and the heating is going to go off. So that's how important a bypass valve is. Without that bypass valve, that is the series of things that can happen that can make the heating system go wrong. Likewise, say the pump is just bashing away and a little bit's just getting around somehow or other through one radiator. You're going to have a boiler that's bashing away. It's still got a life supply going to it, as it has to the pump as well. And that could overheat, could also cause steam. So that's why it's really important to have a bypass valve. And to reiterate it, is so you've got a full flow of hot water through the boiler and the pump at all times, regardless of what any of the controls of the heating system are doing. Another point I'd like to make as well is that last week I went and looked at a job and I saw that they did have a bypass valve on it, but it was on the other side of the two-port valve going to the hot water coil, which made the bypass completely pointless because when that two-port valve was shut, there wasn't any bypass. It was effectively being valved off. So it's very important that the bypass valve is fitted before any controls on the heating system and goes directly back onto the return to the boiler. So how do you set an automatic bypass valve up? Well, usually what I do is, especially on a gate version like the one we've got here, I will basically crack it open about three or four turns, and so you can hear a nice little hiss through it. Also, a great way to test that the bypass valve is working is to make sure that the system is completely cold and then turn on just the heating system radiators. And what you should be able to do then is just turn on this bypass valve here, feel the return pipe and feel that that's getting warm as well. And then you know that it's getting around here without being heated up straight away by the coil and the hot water tank just here. One thing it's worth mentioning as well is that bypass valves are really important when it comes to balancing out a heating system. Because obviously you've got the main flow coming up here, and if this is far too open, then it's going to shove loads of flow down here and back to the boiler. And that means effectively that if the radiators are cooling, they might not be getting the required flow and heat from the boiler that they need. So therefore you've got to think about how you're going to set this little valve up. The great thing about automatic bypass valves is that you don't have to worry about that. Set that to the certain number that you've been told to by the manufacturer, because they're all different, and that's going to open and close automatically because of the pressures that are on the back of the valve. They'll open up completely on their own. The great thing about the Wylos Yonos Pico is it has a little display on it as well, telling us kind of what the outlet pressure is on the pump, which is really, really handy when it comes to kind of demonstrating what a bypass valve does. So at the moment, the system's set up for hot water, which is really good for the little demo we're going to do now. The two-port valve for the radiators is completely shut, and the two-port valve for the hot water system is completely open. And also at the moment, our bypass valve is completely open. So at the moment, the pump knows that the bypass is fully open and that this is open up here, and it's really trying to wang quite a lot of water through at quite a high rate. So now I'm going to strangle down the bypass, which you see that the number on here, which really equates to how much power the pump is putting out, should start to drop because it's being required a lot less. So let's just wind that down. We're at 22 at the moment, getting smaller and smaller. 20, 17, 14. That's completely shut now. 12. This pump is completely slowed down now. It's recognized that there's not enough need for it to have a load of water flying through it. And that's great for this demonstrational video, but obviously if you've got a standard pump, that's just going to carry on going at the same rate. I've strangled this off here as well so we can get a good idea of what the flows are going to be like. So now I'm just going to slowly open this up, and I'm going to get it so it reads about 12. There we go, so it's reading 12 now, it's just slightly open. That means that our bypass is just slightly open, and that's just letting water trickle through regardless of what this two-port valve is doing here and regardless of what any of the valves are doing here. So then we've got our boiler here, we've got our flow coming out of it, we've got our pump, we've got our two-port valves here, one going to the coil in our cylinder and then back to the boiler again, and then one going to the radiators in the house, like so. A nice little single pipe system we've got there, very nice indeed. So the bypass has to go back onto the return. And usually the easiest way for you to do that is because this part here is usually all in the airing cupboard together. So if we just dot this around here, we think that that is all in the airing cupboard, this bit. So what we're gonna do, we tee into this piece here, we put our bypass valve on there, and then that. So we've got water coming out here, up here. So if this shuts or this shuts, water can carry on going up the bypass, back round there, and then you've just got a constant circuit of water like that, regardless of what these two valves do or what any of the thermostatic radiator valves do on the system. So there you go. I hope you've enjoyed today's plumberparts.co.uk video. I hope this has given you a better idea about how bypass valves work and what their position is on the heating system. We were asked to do this video by one of you, our viewers, so thanks ever so much for that question. If you've got any questions or you need any more help or any more information, then ask us in the comments section below or contact us through our Twitter and Facebook. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you in our next plumbing video. Remember everyone, to hold tight.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.